This is Match Game 74, production number 0167. Air date to be announced, VTR 223 of 74, and let's take one. Get ready to match the stars. Bert Convy, Brett Summers, Dick Gautier, Elaine Joyce, Richard Dawson, and Ann Elder. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Rivers.
Hold everything. Stop the music. What does it say there? It says Bugle Boy of Company B.
You got it.
That's an old song. I remember when I used to be a disc jockey many years ago, I used to play there. Hey, yeah, ba da da ba da 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 ba da da. What's that?
Andrew Sisters. 30s.
The Andrew Sisters, yeah.
You know what that's called?
And they're all
What's
in
that
there?
Called?
Tooting your own horn.
Really?
It's
kind of cute.
Jealous again. You see?
That's right, because he doesn't have a bugle.
Well, that's
but he does have a horn.
I happen to have the harp at home.
Well, we welcome all of our celebrated people, and thank you for showing up. Let's say hello to our two players, Chris Lyons and Pam Reinhardt. Hello, ladies. Chris is the current champ with $1,200 to her credit. She's happy about that, and she's being challenged by Pam. We finished round one, and the end of round one, the score was 2-0. And we're going to go to round two right after we go to this message for you. Here it is. Here we go. Round two, I push a button, reveal two questions. Ask Pam, the challenger, to make a selection.
A.
A is what she wants. You didn't match anyone last time around. That means everyone plays. The farmer was so nearsighted, he tried to blank his bull. Got a lot of farmers in the audience, Johnny Olson? I see. You tried to do it too, sir, eh? There's a guy out there, he's waving, he's, yeah, I'm done. Okay, everybody ready? Here we go. We call on Pam for a response. The farmer was so nearsighted, he tried to blank his bull. What do you put in that blank to match these celebrities?
Milk.
Tried to milk his bull. Sir, you out there, is that the what you tried to do? You didn't try to do that. Oh, I see. Let's call on Bert Convy, star of Tattletales, first.
If you've ever seen a mad bull, try to milk one once.
Okay. There's a match. Brett, what do you say?
You know I know how to milk a cow.
Yes. Do you really?
Oh, yeah.
Very few. Listen, it's very difficult.
It is. It's a very tricky number to milk a cow.
Right.
And impossible to milk a bull.
How true. Dick?
I'm with you. What else can you do but try to milk?
It's okay. You're up to three, Pam. Elaine?
Make her very happy.
There's four in a row. Now, let's see if Richard Dawson breaks the spell.
You can milk a bull.
What?
You get a drink with a kick in it. Milk.
All right, Ann,
okay.
It's up to you.
It is.
It is up to you.
Unanimous.
Unanimous. Well, that was unusual, wasn't it? Okay, so that means, Chris, you must match the four remaining celebrities you hadn't matched in the first round to stay in the running and achieve a tie. Good luck to you. Listen carefully. Bert, you will lay out.
Yes.
And so will Richard. Okay, the others will participate. George said to Natalie, every time I get near your blank, I break out in a rash.
George. Can I write anyway just for fun?
Yeah, all right. You can have a little game with me. You show me your answer, I'll show you mine then. George said to Natalie, every time I get near your blank, I break out in a rash.
Oh.
That's.
Every time I get near your milk, I break out.
That's the old answer then. Okay, everybody ready? All right, they are all set. Chris, we call on you. George said to Natalie, every time I get near your blank, I break out in a rash.
Your mother?
Mother. Okay. Got to match everybody up and down the line. That would be his mother-in-law. Brett, what did you say?
Do you know that I had a choice? And one of them was mother, and the other one was body, and I chose body.
You chose body?
Sorry.
No mother, so that means Pam Reinhardt is the winner. That's $100 for you, your first game. If you'll stand by for a moment, we'll have a word with Chris. It's been a real pleasure doing business with you. You're a pretty lady and a gracious contestant. Thank you, Chris Lyons, for being here. You're leaving with $1,200.
Bye-bye.
You didn't think you were going to win? Why didn't you think you were going to win?
Because of that dumb answer I gave the first.
Oh, the first round, yeah. I've forgotten what it was. I repressed those dumb answers very quickly. But here you are. You've got the $100. Don't go away from me. Stick around here with me, because now we're going to have a go at the Big Money Super Match. And you know how that goes?
Yeah.
We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank thumb. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. The next one, $250. The third one, $100. Which three celebrities would you like a little assist from?
Bert.
Bert Convy?
Thank you. Pam, how about Tom Thumb?
Tom Thumb is one.
Dick.
Dick Gautier?
Green Thumb.
Green Thumb.
And Richard.
Richard Dawson. Tom Thumb, Green Thumb.
Well, that's enough for anybody, really.
Yes, you know.
I don't know. Well, Tom Thumb's sister. Fred.
So what's that?
No, I don't.
You can't think of it.
I don't have another thumb.
You know, it's the first time you have ever drawn a blank since you've been on this show.
Well,
and
I can explain that.
How do you explain that? Okay, so you got two answers there, Tom Thumb and Green Thumb. You may choose one of those as the answer, or give us one of your own. Pam, what do you want to do?
I want to go with Tom.
You want to go with Tom? He's going with me. How can you go with... No, I'm only kidding. Tom Thumb is the answer you are looking for, and we'll find out if it's up there. She's hoping it's under the $500 response. We'll start at the bottom and work our way up. May we see the $100 response? Sore Thumb is not a bad answer at all. Okay, still looking for Tom Thumb. Here is the $250 response. Green Thumb is up there, the one that Dick gave you. Now, let's see if Tom Thumb is up there, the one that Bert Convy gave you. Here is the $500 response. Tom Thumb, congratulations. Yeah, because you said Green Thumb, you get to kiss him. All right, congratulations, Pam. You've won the $500. That means you are now playing for 10 times that amount, or... $5,000. But to collect that, you've got to match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis. Please choose one now.
Oh, Bert.
You got to go with Bert again, because you were lucky with him on the first
one. Okay. You almost lucky with her just then.
Bert, you get ready to write. Pam, you face me. And here is the $5,000 question. Blank education. Blank education. All right, Bert has finished his answer. Pam, we need an answer from you now. How do you fill in that blank in an attempt to match him? Blank education.
Sex.
Sex education? They teach that in the schools these days, and I guess people are thinking about it. You think about it much?
No.
No? Oh, okay. All right. Bert, for $5,000, let's find out what you're thinking about.
I think about it a lot, but unfortunately I wrote college education.
College education is a good answer.
I'm sorry.
You know, I didn't think of sex education, but it seems, now that I hear it, is not a bad answer at all.
It's a very good answer.
Very good.
Good
indeed.
Answer, yeah. And yours was good, too, college education.
I taught myself.
You taught yourself? Okay.
Oh,
we suspected that, then.
She taught me, too, as a matter of fact.
And she failed.
Elaine saying she failed. Now, come on, now, let's stop this. Because we got serious business at hand here. We congratulate Pam Reinhardt. You're going to meet another player and play another game right after we pass along this message of interest.
GSN presents...
Charles Nelson Reilly characterized the experience beautifully when he said one day,
"This is not a job, this is a social engagement."
And he was right. We were just a bunch of people who got together and had a good time, and that showed on camera.
Stay tuned for more of That 70s Hour on GSN.
I enjoyed hosting it, I really did.
We are ready to begin a new game. To do that, we have to introduce a new player. So let us all welcome Kathleen Ellis. Hi, Kathleen.
Thank you. Hi.
How are you? You know Pam?
Oh, yes. Yes.
Please tell us a little bit about Kathleen Ellis.
All right. I'm married to a husband.
I wouldn't have it any other way. Yes?
And I have one child, a little girl. Her name is Wendy.
Mm-hmm.
I work part-time. And I'm very happy to be here.
Well, we're happy to have you here, Kathleen. The
Thank
very
you.
Best of luck to you.
Thank you very much.
And to you, champ. Shall we begin? Okay, I'll push the button and reveal two questions. Ask our challenger to make a selection.
B.
She wants B. Everybody plays. Brand new game, folks. Paula said, "My husband, the doctor, treats me like one of his patients. All he ever says to me is blank." Paula said that. "My husband, the doctor, treats me like one of his patients. All he ever says to me is, blank." All right. You're running out of cards. Everybody ready, Kathleen? So we call on you. Paula said, "My husband, the doctor, treats me like one of his patients. All he ever says to me is, blank."
Undress.
Undress. That's a very good answer, I think, Kathleen. I think now that I hear that, I would have said that, too, if I were playing this game. What'd you say, Bert?
I said that. I said I'm blessed.
There's a match for you, Kathleen. What do you say, Brett?
Well, you know I didn't say undress because I try never to be smart enough to match the contestants, evidently.
Just works out that way.
I don't know. I think my mind's going or gone. I said lie down and take an aspirin.
Lie down, take an aspirin.
I wish I were dead. Is what I wish.
That's not a bad answer. You know, that's a traditional joke about doctors.
Have you ever seen a woman cry on the air?
No, don't cry. Brett, no, Brett, that's not a bad answer at all. Dick, tell her it's a good answer.
It's a bad answer. But I also have a bad answer, so what?
Cry together.
I said, say ah.
Say ah. That's not too bad. I think Kathleen's is better. What did you say, Miss Bugle Boy of Company B?
I said next.
Next? Some good answers from these crazy people up here there. How about you, sir?
What's that?
Oh, read the question. Oh, yeah, I forgot that would say so. Paula said, "My husband, the doctor, treats me like one of his patients. All he ever says to me is..."
I don't like that. Read another question.
That's what I got.
I always say, and it always works. Undress.
Undress. Well, that's two for you, Kathleen.
Do that business where you read the question.
No, you know what the question is. Paula says, "My doctor..."
Yes, I know. He said, "Next."
Next. Oh, yeah. Okay. So hers was undressed, and that scored twice for her. And now let's see how Pam does in her first round question. Elaine Joyce said... Elaine Joyce said...
"Play my bugles."
I enjoy being pretty. But I sure get tired of people staring at my blank. You've got to write an answer because you are participating. Yes, everyone participates. Bert is ready. You remember Elaine Joyce?
Yeah.
Well, this girl Elaine Joyce said...
"The truth?"
All right. All set up there, Brett? Okay. Elaine Joyce said, and you know that's Elaine Joyce over there. You're aware of that. "I enjoy being pretty, but I sure get tired of people staring at my...
boobs."
Okay. All right. Her answer is what she said, yeah. And what's yours?
Well, taking in mind what she has on, the shirt there, I said staring at her bugles, which I think...
at her bugles.
Oh, oh, that's,
that
oh,
does not
it's
match?
There.
Wait a minute.
It's a synonym. Yeah. Oh, we're gonna fight them out, Dan.
Yeah, that's a very nice euphemism for yes, boobs absolutely. In this case, because she's wearing yes. the bugle right yes, on her boobs there. Yes. Brett, what did you say?
I said Jean Rainbird, yeah. honestly.
Yes.
That's what I said. I just say if at first you don't succeed, try again. And no offense, Elaine, I said roots.
Roots. Is applauding that touch of hostility in that answer, I dare say.
Oh, okay. I have to forgive.
Forgive her.
Well,
you forgive Brett.
Yes.
The parking lot,
he's
Brett.
Happy she just got the lead playing Wallace Beery in his lifestyle.
Dick Gautier, what did you say?
Well, I use the Swedish word for boobs, which is viewers. Look at my
bugles. All right, there's another man. Well, there's been so much tomfoolery, I think I better repeat the question just so in case you forgot it. Elaine Joyce said, I enjoy being pretty, but I sure get tired of people staring at my... And now, Elaine Joyce, we come to the moment of truth.
This is the moment of truth.
Yeah.
Body.
Body. There's nothing wrong with your body, is there?
That's why I keep staring at it.
That's all I see. Okay. How about you, sir? What was your answer?
This has told me more about trumpets since I dated Doc Severinsen. I said bust.
Bust, okay. Now, Anne.
Yes. Oh, I said the nice word. I said Elaine's bugles.
Elaine's bugles.
Yeah,
okay. So, at the end of round one, we've got a pretty good game going here. It's 4-2 in favor of you, Pam. And round two follows round one, and that happens anon.
Today's consolation prizes are West Clock's new Almanac Wall Clock, contemporary design clock with day and date feature that changes automatically. From West Clock's Italy Industries Company. And the InSinkerator hot water dispenser gives you 190-degree water at your kitchen sink like having a tea kettle always ready. From InSinkerator. And AstroTurf Doormats, a fresh new way to say welcome. Combines beauty, durability, and charm. AstroTurf Doormats for all seasons from Monsanto. And Profile with its own great flavor from a special formula of cracked wheat and wheat germ, just right for toast. Profile, it's a matter of taste. More blanks to fill on Match Game 74 in 1 minute.
Oh, boy, here we go. Ladies, we finished with round one, and we are going directly to round two without stopping at go or anything like that. So, Kathleen, would you make a selection?
B
is what she wants. Now, last time, Kathleen, you matched Richard and Bert, so the two of you gentlemen will not write. The rest will. Last night, Charlie the Tuna was blank for dinner. Last night, Charlie the Tuna was blank for dinner.
I love you in beige. Oh, golly. I go crazy when you come out in beige.
I didn't know what she was going to say.
Your silk blouse is terrific.
Thank you.
That's real silk, and you can tell.
Oh,
a classy
yeah,
feather.
Right.
Isn't that real silk?
Absolutely.
That is real silk.
All right, that's enough.
That's enough. Yes. Here we go. Okay, everybody sit over there. We didn't answer from you, Kathleen. Last night, Charlie the Tuna was blank for dinner.
Served.
Served for dinner is what she says. Brett, what do you say?
I say served.
Served for dinner is a man. Had a girl. What do you say?
I said eaten. Isn't
eaten
that
and
wonderful?
Served. Is that a match?
Yeah.
Yeah, that is a match. Okay. What do you got here? Eaten is another one for you. And Ann Elder.
Caught and served.
Caught and served. Boy, did you give the right answer that time,
woo!
Kathleen. You're up to six. And Pam, that means you've got to match it to two celebrities you have not matched in the first round. And that they are Brett and Elaine. That's getting so exciting. Listen carefully now. On his 107th birthday, Grandpa Jones said, about the only thing I can do these days is blank.
Hey,
Elaine's own birthday. Write something down there. Oh, okay. Would you like to read the question?
Don't trace it.
All right. All right, we'll figure it out. Okay, Pam, can we get your response on his 107th birthday? Grandpa Jones said, about the only thing I can do these days is blank.
Tinkle.
She has no respect for old age. She said tinkle.
He's tinkled enough.
Now, she must say tinkle, and she must say tinkle for you to stay in the game.
This time I said breathe.
Breathe. So you think I'm not sure, and that means Kathleen Nelson is the winner. Congratulations, Kathleen. You've got $100. Are you happy about that?
Yes, very happy.
Well, Pam, your championship was short-lived, but you're not leaving empty-handed. You have a total of $600, together with our thanks for being on Match Game 74. Pam Reinhardt, very pretty, nice lady. Now, you're going to have a go at the Big Money Super Match, but we've got a little business to do here first. Okay, you stand by. Will you do that? Listen, you are all just as good as you could possibly be. This is I really enjoyed myself.
But we'll have to do better, is that right?
And let's all remember to look for Bert Convy immediately following us on CBS here in his own show, Tattletales, a terrific production.
Thank you, James.
Oh, he's terrific, isn't it?
See you in a minute.
See all of you next time. G-Labor from Match Game 74. Bye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 74. Goodson, Bill Chapman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of these CBS stations.
Pam, that's $100 for you, your first game. If you'll stand by for a moment, we'll have a word with Chris. It's been a real pleasure doing business with you. You're a pretty lady and a gracious contestant. Thank you, Chris Lyons, for being here. You're leaving with $1,200.
You didn't think you were going to win?
Why didn't you think you were going to win?
Because of that dumb answer I gave the first.
Oh, the first round, yeah. I've forgotten what it was. I repressed those dumb answers very quickly. But here you are. You've got the $100. Don't go away from me. Stick around here with me because now we're going to have a go at the Big Money Super Match. And you know how that goes?
Yeah.
We polled a recent studio audience and we got their best response to this. Blank thumb. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. The next one, $250. The third one, $100. Which three celebrities would you like a little assist from?
Bert.
Bert Convy?
Thank you. Pam, how about Tom Thumb?
Tom Thumb is one.
Dick.
Dick Gautier?
Green Thumb.
Green Thumb.
And Richard.
Richard Dawson. Tom Thumb, Green Thumb.
Well, that's enough for anybody, really.
Yes, you know.
I don't know. Well, Tom Thumb's sister. Fred.
So. What's that?
No, I don't.
You can't think of
it. I don't have another thumb.
You know, it's the first time you have ever drawn a blank since you've been on this show.
Well,
and
I can explain that.
How do you explain that? Okay, so you got two answers there, Tom Thumb and Green Thumb. You may choose one of those as the answer or give us one of your own. Pam, what do you want to do?
I want to go with Tom.
You want to go with Tom? He's going with me. How can you go with... No, I'm only kidding. Tom Thumb is the answer you are looking for, and we'll find out if it's up there. She's hoping it's under the $500 response. We'll start at the bottom and work our way up. May we see the $100 response. Sore Thumb is not a bad answer at all. Okay, still looking for Tom Thumb. Here is the $250 response. Green Thumb is up there, the one that Dick gave you. Now, let's see if Tom Thumb is up there, the one that Bert Convy gave you. Here is the $500 response. Tom Thumb, congratulations. Terrific. Yeah, come back here now. Get back to Green.
Do you
want to
get anything for Green?
Yeah. Yeah, because he's a green thumb, you get to kiss him. All right, congratulations, Pam. You've won the $500. That means you are now playing for 10 times that amount, or... $5,000. But to collect that, you've got to match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis. Please choose one now.
Oh, Bert.
You got to go with Bert again because you were lucky with him on the spot.
Okay. You almost got lucky with her just then.
Bert, you get ready to write. Pam, you face me. And here is the $5,000 question. Blank education. Blank education. That, and she's being challenged by Pam. We finished round one, and the end of round one, the score was 2-0. And we're going to go to round two right after we go to this message for you. Here it is. Here we go. Round two, I push a button, reveal two questions. Ask Pam, the challenger, to make a selection.
A.
A is what she wants. You didn't match anyone last time around. That means everyone plays.
What?
The farmer was so nearsighted, he tried to blank his bull. He tried to blank his bull. Got a lot of farmers in the audience, Johnny Olson? I see. You tried to do it too, sir, eh? There's a guy out there, he's waving, he's, yeah, I done. Okay, everybody ready? Here we go. We call on Pam for a response. The farmer was so nearsighted, he tried to blank his bull. What do you put in that blank to match these celebrities?
Milk.
Tried to milk his bull. Sir, you out there, is that the what you tried to do? You didn't try to do that. Oh, I see. Let's call on Bert Convy, star of Tattletales, first.
If you've ever seen a mad bull, try to milk one once.
Okay. There's a match. Brett, what do you say?
You know I know how to milk a cow.
Yes. Do you really?
Oh, yeah.
Very few. Listen, it's very difficult.
It is. It's a very tricky number to milk a cow.
Right.
And impossible to milk a bull.
How true. Dick?
I'm with you. What else can you do but try to milk?
It's okay. You're up to three, Pam. Elaine?
We're going to make her very happy.
There's four in a row. Now, let's see if Richard Dawson breaks his spell.
You can milk a bull.
What?
You get a drink with a kick in it. Milk.
All right, Anne, okay. It's up to you.
It is.
It is up to you.
Unanimous.
Unanimous. Well, that was unusual, wasn't it? Okay, so that means, Chris, you must match the four remaining celebrities you hadn't matched in the first round to stay in the running and achieve a tie. Good luck to you. Listen carefully. Bert, you will lay out.
Yes.
And so will Richard. Okay, the others will participate. George said to Natalie, every time I get near your blank, I break out in a rash.
George. Can I write anyway just for fun?
Yeah, all right. You can have a little game with me. You show me your answer, I'll show you mine then. George said to Natalie, every time I get near your blank, I break out in a rash.
Oh.
Yes.
Every time I get near your milk, I break out.
That's the old answer then. Okay, everybody ready? All right, they are all set. Chris, we call on you. George said to Natalie, every time I get near your blank, I break out in a rash.
Your mother?
Mother. Okay. Gotta match everybody up and down the line. That would be his mother-in-law. Brett, what did you say?
You know that I had a choice. And one of them was mother, and the other one was body, and I chose body.
You chose body?
Sorry.
No mothers, then he's Pam Reinhardt.
This is Match Game 74, production number 0167. Air date to be announced, VTR 223 of 74, and it's take one. Get ready to match the stars. Bert Convy, Brett Summers, Dick Gautier, Elaine Joyce, Richard Dawson, and Ann Elder. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. Joyce of Match Game 74, Gene Rivers.
Hold everything. Stop the music. What does it say there? It says Bugle Boy of Company B.
You got it.
That's an old song. I remember when I used to be a disc jockey many years ago. I used to play there. Hey, yeah, but what's that?
Andrew Sisters. 30s.
The Andrew Sisters, yeah.
You know what that's called?
And they're all
what's
in
that
there?
Called?
Tooting your own horn.
Really?
It's
kind of cute.
Jealous again. You see?
That's right, because he doesn't have a bugle.
Well, that's so.
But he does have a horn.
I happen to have the harp at home.
Well, we welcome all of our celebrated people, and thank you for showing up. Let's say hello to our two players, Chris Lyons and Pam Reinhardt. Hello, ladies. Chris is the current champ with $1,200 to her credit. She's happy about